My name is Rikard König, and I'm a CTO and co-founder of Ekkono Solutions. As you probably know, Ekkono's product is a library for edge machine learning. And in the next 5 minutes, I'm going to explain the main difference between cloud and edge analytics, and when you should consider to use edge machine learning. So the cloud or centralized approach to data analysis is today widely adapted, and many companies are putting considerable resources into ensuring a steady flow of data to their machine algorithms in the cloud. This is no surprise, since the approach has many success stories. For example, American Express claims that they can identify 24% of the customers who will close their accounts within the next 4 months using machine learning. And Walmart says that they can increase the completion rate of online purchases with 15% by providing more relevant search results using machine learning. So what's important to realize is that the big challenge in this application is not the number of individual subjects or users. Since you have more or less unlimited resources in the cloud and the data collection frequency is rather low, like 1 or 2 records per day. No, the challenge is instead the big variation in users' behavior and how each user is influenced by numerous known and unknown sources. And if you compare this to the applications related to industrial IoT and devices such as pumps, electrical motors, fans, etc., you instead encounter applications where the data collection frequency is high, like several data points per second, while the number of subjects or machines is comparable low, like in the hundreds or thousands of devices. And the subjects or the machines are comparably very similar, but may act in very different environments, where all operating conditions often cannot be monitored with sensors. So what does this mean? Well, the challenges in both cases is the variability of the subjects and their environments. In the cloud or centralized approach, these challenges is handled by collecting huge amounts of data from a very large number of subjects and adding vast computing resources to solve the problem. But for IoT devices, this approach is often not applicable due to the cost of sending data to the cloud or under an unreliable connectivity, latency, due to the round trip to the cloud and back. And these challenges increases with higher data collection frequency and is a real deal breaker for automation and safety critical applications. And if you can't send the data to the cloud, you must process it on the device. But here you can't pour endless computing resources on the problem. You will also be restricted to data from a single device. But this is not always so bad, because if we model each device individually, we simplify the problem. We no longer need to explain how our machines differ or why they behave differently. We only need to explain a specific behavior. And this also solves a part of the data processing problem, since each device only needs to process its own data. And if you distribute the computation over time using Ekkono's optimized edge machine learning library, you can even make devices with tiny microcontrollers such as ARM's M0 Plus smart. So to summarize, both edge and cloud analytics has its uses, where edge is the best alternative if you have a higher data collection frequency. And by processing data on the device, you also drastically reduce the amount of data that you need to send to the cloud, but also increasing reliability and response time, which is crucial if you're doing automation. And by creating one model per device, you only need to explain the behavior of a single unit. This approach also makes it computationally feasible, and again, with Ekkono's edge machine learning library, you can do it using only a fraction of the resources available on even the smallest microcontroller. That was all for today. Thank you for your attention.